we start, I was hesitating a bit actually to mention, to raise that again, as Alexia had already hinted at this during her talk, but I thought it's worth stressing this again. So as a quick reference, there's Bill's excellent presentation yesterday, and with me being an economist, I was taking a gasp for a moment when I heard Bill point out that Wolfgang found economics wanting in some ways, or even in many ways. So my first thought was, oh dear, does that have to do with the research group on population economics? Does it even have to do with you? But then my second thought was that if Wolfgang finds something wanting, it being Wolfgang, it means that he actually has a great interest in this issue, and that he has certainly thought about this very long and hard and read. And in fact, it's this very spirit, I mean, I hope Wolfgang agrees, and it's this very spirit in which Wittgenstein Center is being run. It's driven by a genuine interest in topics and substance, but also in scientific approaches. And certainly, we as economists, I think I can speak for everyone here, are benefiting from that, but so are all other social scientists who come together in this institute. And to create such an atmosphere of openness, of interaction, of interchange, of mutual interest, to foster something and develop it into something which is the best of all worlds, I think that's generally unique. And besides Wolfgang's scientific achievements, I think that is something which cannot be esteemed high enough. So thank you very much, Wolfgang. I mean, we are all benefiting from your leadership in that respect. So, now. It's a great pleasure to have another old fellow traveler of with Wolfgang, not old, but long-lasting, Graziella Caselli, who is presenting on actual fairness and social inequality, which I understand is a very topical issue for her, yes. Even personally at the moment. So,
yes.
Floor is yours.
Very new, very ambitious. So, I would like to give you an overview of our pension system, and really I would like to present you the last news at the end of my presentation. And I try to explain you how the actuarial fairness produces social inequality. This work is done with a colleague of ISTAT, because ISTAT is the data for calculating the pension system. So the aim of my presentation is to analyze the issue of the actuarial fairness in the Italian public pension system in view of the trends in all the age survival differences by gender and age. I would like to present you some news on population dynamics, Italian population dynamics, and some news on survival in all the ages. And so I would like to present briefly the conversion factors needs the conversion factor for calculating annuity pension, the benefit. So, and now I try to give an answer to this question, how to reduce social inequalities reduced by actuarial fairness. So, I think this pyramid is very long. This is the last Italian pyramid. We have 22% of population aged 65 and over, and besides, the women are 24.4. And so this aged population will increase on the time year by year, and in 31 we are waiting for 26%. But it's normally because if I consider the absolute differences from 11 to 31, it's clear that the population until 50, in particular the adult population, decrease, and we have a very important increase in old ages, in particular in ages 60 to 70, in the baby boomers' cohorts that arrive at this age in 31. So, but we have also a very important increase in life expectancy at 65. I call your attention on the fact that the last table in 14 The life expectancy for men at 65 was 19, as for women was 22.3. We have 3.4 years of differences between women and men, and but we have a very important increase starting from 1995, the first year of that we have this reform, until today, because for men the life expectancy at 65 increased to 3.2 years as 2.7 for women. So, this figures is very clear. 95 equal to 100, the most important increase is for men, both for women, ages 65 and 80. We have a very important increase in life expectancy for old people. So, but just this year, some months ago, ISTAT published the life tables by level of education, referring to the years 2012. I call your attention on the last line, is life expectancy 65, and I consider here only the men and women for low and high education. The low educated men, in comparison with higher educated men, as the differences in life expectancy 65 is 2 years. As for women is 1.2. So the differences for men and women in life, in total life expectancy is 3.4. If we consider the higher educated women and low educated men, the difference is 5 years. It's very important. Eh? And so, of course, in Italy, as in other countries, many reforms of the welfare system have been introduced by Italian governments in order to face the aging problem and the relative sustainability of pension expenditure. But the most important was the called Dini reform in 1995. This reform changed the pay-as-you-go public pension system from a defined benefit to a defined contribution scheme. It's based on the principle of actuarial fairness, and the reform at the time should be fully operative around 30-35. So slowly, slowly we move from pay-as-you-go to contributive system. But in 2012, the government decided to reform our system, and the Fornero reform, switching to a totally contributive system for all from 1st January 2012, instead of 2030-35. This, of course, is a revolution. So the pension reform is built on the principle of actuarial fairness, as I said. Not enough consideration has been given to gender or any other characteristic except age. The system introduced by the reform can only be actuarially fair for those Italians whose survival probabilities happen to coincide with the average. For all the other, the system is more or less than actuarially fair, depending on whether the survival probabilities are above or below the average. So, in our contributive system, the pension benefit depends on age and retirement, as I said, but of course, of the capitalized value of lifetime social security contribution, that I call, coming from now, M. But this M is converted into a real pension annuity called DX using a set of legislated coefficients named conversion factor, CTF at age X, computed by taking into account, among other things, of course, average survival probability in the various age and retirements. What is mean? So, the Dini reform decided to update the CTF every 10 years. And with the increasing life expectancy, of course, it's a very long period. In 12, for the reform, decided that the conversion factor will be updated every 3 years, starting from 1 January 2013, and to extend the age of retirement to age 70, in place of 65. Today, the retirement age is for men 66.7 and for women 65.7, but starting from 19, it will be equal for men and women, of course equal to 65, plus the increase of life expectancy on the basis of the table constructed in 2017, because the table employed is referred to 2 years before. So, this annual pace of benefit and retirement is equal, of course, of M multiplied by CTFX. This, as I said, is the price value of lifetime social security contributors, and this is the legislative conversion factors for retirement at age X. Of course, this is equal 1 on the X. This is the present value of an annuity. But, as I said, they decided to not consider the disparity, no difference, and for this, the CTFX is the average, the average of the CTF for men plus CTF for women. It means to have a sort of probabilities, an average of the probabilities men and women. So, briefly, the first part of the X, A, is the direct pension. The second part is the indirect pension. I would like to see you that in this figure I write paid to the surviving spouse. Now we have a new law, not submitted to referendum, fortunately, that said the indirect pension is available also for his or her partner. It not depends to the marriage, the civil law. So, and then, this is the formula, but briefly, I would like to take your attention on the fact that the only financial parameter that we have in this formula is I, is the annual rate discount rates. This rate is fixed, is always the same, coming from 95 until today, doesn't change. So, just briefly, the important parameters in this formula are the demographic parameters. The survival, life tables, the survival for pensioner, the survival for widow, in the second part, and the differences, who is the probability of death for widow, and another demographic parameter is the differences in age by the two partners. Generally, if men die, the woman is 3 years younger than his partner. So, our coefficient depends, the changing in our parameters depends on the demographic parameters. I give you this image, very, very interesting, I think. The first ETF calculated until 09, and the second one calculated until 10-12. So, and I would like to call your attention on the fact that today the age of retirement, 66.7, has the same coefficient that the retired people had 4 years before at 65. So, the age of the time increase, but the coefficient decrease. It means that the age of the time increase, but the annuity pension decrease or stay always the same. It needs to go out at 70 for having a very interesting conversion factor, and so the annuity pension. But it's normally because also. It's normal because the life expectancy is defined in the principle of time. So, I'll give you just an example of the result in our annuity pension. If I take constant for all, the M, constant for all, of course, is higher for the high-related people and lower for the other. And if I consider this coefficient in 09, 13, 15, and 16, 18, and the annuity pension is 16,500 euro. But if I consider the CTF calculated in 1315, is lower, almost 2,000 euro, is a very low annuity pension, eh? A decrease, a very important decrease. But if I consider a day after 30 December 15, is decreased again, and the differences between 09 and today is 30% minus at the same ages. So we calculate that the, well, when we're moving from basic or, no, when we're moving from 12 to 13, whereas the new reform, the retired people in average lose the 90% of the annual pension. The shock. So anyway, if I try to calculate the CTF for men and CTF for women, their differences are explain the disadvantage for men and advantage for women. But the decided the gender differences need to be taken into account, as women have much more discontinuity during their working career due to childbirth, and their higher benefit balance of this discontinuity. No possibility to change our system considering the differences by gender. But it exists. But if I take into account for an individual the impact of the level of education on life expectancy. So if I put the differences, considering the life expectancy is an example, 65 is the level of life expectancy employed in the pension system, is equal for men and women. These differences considering level of education and gender, of course in year 2012, because we have the table in 2012, it's so clear that the low educated men has a low life expectancy, higher than 2, and high educated women is higher life expectancy, about 3. This is a 5 years of difference between the two sexes, but only the higher educated men is almost the same life expectancy, the same survival considered in our CTF in the pension system. So, if I calculate as estimate, the legislator conversion factors and so annuity pension, considering this is a legislator conversion factor for low educated men, low educated women, and high educated men, high educated women, is possible, probably in this figure, to look what important is the disadvantage for men, low educated men, the advantages for high educated women. The first thing I note is that for low educated men, but also for higher educated men, the CTF decrease with age. It means that these people go to retirement at 70, their conversion factor is in reality lower than if retired at 65 or before. It's a contrary for women, because for women, low educated and high educated, this conversion factor decreases. So we have a gain also in this way, huh? But in particular, the difference is about more than 5% for women. So I'm concluding. So this, I think, is very important. So just an example, considering the low-educated men and educated women, lower and high-educated men, sorry, oh my God. The low-educated men, and these differences is just explain the impact of the annuity redistribution from lower to higher survival group. Of course, the level of education generally is a proxy of socioeconomic condition. If I consider the comparison from low-educated men, high-educated women, the differences is so higher. 1,000 differences in the pension estimated is 70% of the difference, disadvantage for men, two versus two, higher than the women. So it's playing part the impact of the annuity redistribution from lower survival men to higher survival women. Just to conclude, in this presentation, we have tried to highlight the importance of differential demographic processes and, in particular, the strategic role played by mortality variations when calculating the conversion factors that present one of the key elements of the new Italian system of public pensions. Not all pensions, we know, are on an equal footing with regard to death. But generally, we must recognize that the actuarial fairness of the system introduced by the Italian reform can only be guaranteed on average, and that in the presence of a heterogeneous population of individuals that differ considerably in their mortality prospects, the current system implies a substantial degree of redistribution from higher mortality groups, typically characterized by low income, low wealth, to low mortality groups, typically characterized by higher income and higher wealth. So it means that actuarial fairness produces and will produce an increase in social inequalities. But I would like to see you that if the Senato today vote the last proposal, the proposal of Renzi government, finished but the proposition, probably it will be voted in definitive way today, the government decided to mitigate this increase in inequalities and to reduce the retirement age probably in about 2 years for all individuals belonging to the lower socioeconomic group, considering the lower life expectancy. An average 1.7 for men and women together, just close to my results, 1.2 is about 1.6, 1.7. And for the first time, 1 year and a half ago, they decided to ask to demography epidemiologists to calculate the life expectancy for all socio-professional groups and to group together the individual that have an life expectancy lower than the other, and to make some flexibility. So it means that we go to the retired in retirement 2 years before, but the CTF, it will be the same of the other people that retire at 66.7. Thank you for your attention, and of course, happy.